save you from my wrath!
Stop right there, villain! Yeah, what he said. It's morphin' time! Dragon Bakura!
Whoa. Wrong show.
It's the right show because, you know, Jew Ranger, that footage was used for the Green Ranger Mighty Morphing, so either or.
Still, wrong show.
I don't have time for this. That monster really got us good.
Yeah, we should have spent more time fighting than bickering. Then maybe we would have had a chance against him.
Well, let's not make a similar mistake with today's video.
Alright, welcome viewers to today's episode of Import Legacy. I'm Bilal.
And I'm Andrew. Today we'll be discussing the tokusatsu genre soon as we find a light switch.
We start our journey in Japan on January 2nd, 1966, when Tsuburaya Productions airs the first episode of Ultra Q, a sci-fi mystery show centered around kaiju and weird occurrences. It was pretty much the Japanese equivalent of The Twilight Zone. The show had approximately 28 episodes and ended syndication on December 14th, 1967.
This show has relevance to the tokusatsu genre because it was the precursor and the basis for the show Ultraman, which heralded the birth of the tokusatsu and henshin hero genre.
Following the exploits of a transforming hero who fights evil, and the medium was conveyed through the use of immense special effects for explosions, monsters, transformations, etc.
While Eiji Tsuburaya inspired the live-action aspect of tokusatsu, another pioneer would come along to create the tropes and themes of the genre, that being Satoru Ishinomori, who defined the term henshin, meaning to transform. His contributions can be attributed to Cyborg 009, 1964, and Skullman, 1970, both influential in their own way.
Cyborg 009 was the first Japanese superhero team and kickstarted the concept of cyborg superheroes. First popularized by Ishinomori's mentor, Osamu Tezuka, in his creation, Might Atom, aka Astro Boy.
And Skullman for being credited as the first Japanese anti-hero, which Ishinomori loved to use, and the precursor of the Kamen Rider series. In fact, he made a cameo of sorts in Skullman, where Detective Hyoka ended up being captured by the villain group Syndicate and turned into a grasshopper-type creature.
Speaking of which, the concept of Kamen Rider being insect-themed was due to Ishinomori's son suggesting the idea. When Kamen Rider was released in 1971, Ishinomori made a manga to coincide with the live-action series.
There are several differences between the two. In the manga, it was a seemingly hopeless battle against the Shocker, an organization bigger than either one of the writers, with governmental conspiracies. In the show, it was a little bit more upbeat. The writers were able to overcome Shocker, only to be replaced by a similar organization, and thus the cycle continued yet again.
Unlike the show, the manga followed the complete journey of Takeshi Hongo. However, in the show, the actor who played Hongo was saddened with an injury, and Kamen Rider photographer Ichimonji was chosen as his temporary replacement.
The series was popular enough to spawn new installments, and thus a franchise was born. This also brought in new franchises to rise from its success.
One of those being Super Sentai, starting with 1975's Gold Ranger, which, like Kamen Rider, became a big-time franchise that still continues today.
Basically, a team of five, along with a mentor and their giant robot, would fight against all kinds of villains and monsters. Though the giant robot element did not start with Go Ranger.
What?
Yeah, that actually started with Toei's adaptation of Spider-Man. Yes, that exists, and it's crazy as hell. That series started the concept of giant monsters battling giant robots with Spider-Man's mech, Leopardon. Super Sentai eventually borrowed this with Daidenzin in Denzin Man.
That and other elements of the show were incorporated into the modern Super Sentai formula, which, after a couple of decades, became pretty stale, especially with the failure of 1990's Five Men.
Thankfully, Jetman and Judanger were able to get Super Sentai back on track with their more soap opera-esque storylines.
And years after Judanger's success, Saban Entertainment gained the rights to Super Sentai and produced Judanger into the popular Mighty Morphin Power Rangers in the West.
Using the same formula as Super Sentai, except a different team each series. Originally, Power Rangers would have had the same team progressing as the show went on, up until Lost Galaxy, adapted off of Ginga Man.
Currently, Power Rangers is on its 25th season with Super Ninja Steel. Super Sentai is on its 41st with Q-Ranger.
And Kamen Rider with both the second season of Amazons and Kamen Rider Build.
That's all the time we have for now, folks. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel.
Follow us on Twitter and Instagram.
And smash the like button on our Facebook page.
And
is that it?
Yeah, that's it.
We should probably go stop that monster outside.
Yeah, we should.